New developments tonight in a story WRTV Investigates first brought you last month about a Greenfield headstone business accused of taking people's money and not finishing the job. The Indiana Attorney General's office has filed a lawsuit against Greenfield Granite and is taking action to stop the company from removing or selling any headstones on the property. WRTV Investigates' Kara Kenny has been tracking this and joins us now with what this means for grieving families.
The Indiana Attorney General's office filed a 40-page lawsuit against Greenfield Granite, accusing the company of violating the Indiana Deceptive Consumer Sales Act. WRTV Investigates first raised questions about Greenfield Granite's business practices on August 20th. We introduce you to grieving families awaiting headstones and refunds, like Sheila Carson, who ordered her mother's headstone from Greenfield Granite over a year ago, but it was never placed.
We've missed all these holidays with her to, you know, somewhere to go and visit and put flowers out. And it's been excuse after excuse.
On September 8th, the company's owner, Amy Stroll, died by suicide amid a criminal investigation. With the company's future in flux, Sheila and other families are concerned the company may try to sell or get rid of their loved one's gravestones. Sheila shared with us this picture of her mother's finished headstone sitting outside of Greenfield Granite over the weekend. On Friday, the Attorney General's office filed this lawsuit accusing the company of deceptive practices and also filed for a temporary restraining order.
So a temporary restraining order is filed to ask the court to say, hey, let's put everything on pause, let's put everything on hold, and require the individuals associated with the company not to do things, not to distribute any assets, not to write any checks, not to do anything along those lines, to allow for the court to take a deeper look into what's going on.
A judge agreed, so that means Greenfield Granite can't remove or dispose of any property until a hearing can be held. The AG's office is also seeking more than $20,000 in restitution for customers and to help families get their headstones if possible. While Stroll's death will make things more complicated, the AG's office is confident it can help consumers get some resolution. The Attorney General's office is asking anyone with a complaint against Greenfield Granite to file a complaint with their office at indianaconsumer.com. Working for you, Kara Kenny, WRTV.
WRTV Investigates is working on getting a response from Greenfield Granite. A court hearing is scheduled for next Tuesday in Hancock County Court.